Alrighty, friends, back again today with another exciting video here. We're going to talk about part two of the 1993 Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles original Playmates Mirage Studio action figure line. A lot to say right there. But first, we're going to start with this figure that you've probably never seen before in your life. I have to say, the most rarest Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle action figure in the world. And yes, I'm lying. This is obviously a bootleg called Ninja Frog. I believe this was out in the 90s. Not a lot of information on this thing other than people selling them. And there's several different ones, at least two that I know of. So at least two, maybe not several. But there's this one. There's another one with a patch on his eye. I would like to get the whole set just to have a whole set of these bootlegs. But yeah, I'll put up a picture of somebody selling one that has it in the original box. Well, they have the original box. It's opened. And they're selling it for like 180 bucks. I don't know why. I purchased this thing for under 20 bucks. I don't understand how rare these things are. I've never seen one before, so I had to get it. But, yeah, I just want to show this little thing. Basically, it's just a little plastic figure. Well, they're all plastic, right? But he's attached to this skateboard, and it does have a little operation, thing down here to turn on and off. Now, when I purchased this, they said it was untested. So I was like, all right, I'm probably going to get something that doesn't work, but you know, I just wanted to look at this fancy bootleg turtle because he's so cool looking, right? So cheaply made. But yeah, before we get into the part two of the 93, let's see if this guy works. Looks like he's turning on. There he goes. Right there. How fantastic is that guy? Alrighty, so to start off part two of the 1993 Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle original Playmates action figures, we're going to talk about the movie 3 action figure line first, and we're going to start off with the turtles, and then we'll look at some of the other figures. It shouldn't be a real long video, as there's quite a bit of figures, but we're just going to talk about movie 3 today, and that's it. So let's do that right now. Let's start off with Donatello, which is, of course, my favorite, and he does have his bow staff and his scepter with something inside of it there. So he does have that, those two accessories. He is missing everything else, including the mask and a piece of armor that goes in the crotch region there. But I don't know, I've always loved these armored samurai armored looking figures, man. They've always been really cool. Some of my favorites, even though they were made in high quantity, so they're not really rare to find. Now the Shogun armored figures are a lot more scarce to come by than these guys. But, I don't know. I like both of them. I like this armor, and of course the Shogun's nice and shiny, fancy armor, but yeah, you gotta like this stuff. But this is Donatello, and like I said, he's in pretty decent shape. I will have to get, you know, his armor piece for his crotch and his mask and everything to complete this guy. I might have to replace this figure. Who knows? But everything else, he's really good shape. I don't see any paint rub marks. Really cool. Really cool looking figure, nonetheless. So let's just set him off to the side over here and take a look at Raphael next on the list here. Now, I pretty much have all his accessories except for his scepter and I think and his mask, of course. But as you can see, which we'll just take a look at real quick. Well, let's look at the figure, then we'll look at the box. But again, overall, really good shape with his equipment here. Yeah. Like I said, they made these guys in mass quantities. They're not real hard to find, even in the box. So let's just look at that box real quick. Now, as you can see, like I said before, I have all the armor pieces with the loose figure, but he's missing the mask and the scepters in there. Pretty cool. But both of them in very good shape. I don't notice any very good loose figure there. Now let's look at the back of the box here. Now we got all the figures from this line, which we'll be going over because we have all of them here. But there you go. You got the Warhorse figures. You got the Catapult, the Turtlepult. And then you got all the action figures right here. So that's what you got with that. Cool stuff. Nonetheless, guys, I love me some Samurai Turtles. That's for damn sure. So let's move on to... Now, let's put this box over here so we have some room here. We got Michelangelo here with his accessories, if I can pick everything up. So he comes with this stuff, and he's pretty much complete. He has his mask. He's got all his accessories, his nunchucks. So little Mikey here is complete. We can take his mask off, pop that thing off. See his face. See his smiling, glorious face there. I think he's smiling, right? Is that grinning? I don't know, but Mikey always looks pretty decent. He always looks a little crazy. But very good shape, like the other figures. There is, of course, some paint rub marks back here we see, but I don't notice a lot of paint rubbing off of this guy. So that's excellent. This will definitely be one that I will keep in my collection. So let's put Mikey over here. Oh, he fell over. Move those accessories out of the way. Okay, so we got Leonardo here. Take his mask off. Maybe. There. So there we go. We got Leonardo. He's got one katana with him. And, of course, the scepter. And as always, with all the figures, I'll put his photo up next so you can see what all he came with. But, again, he does have some paint rub marks I can see, especially on the helmet up here. But overall, he's in really good shape, too. Very cool figure. Yeah, cool stuff. I don't even think we looked at the dates, but I don't think they made replicas or knockoffs of these. There's just so many of them. 1993 Mirage Studios, Playmates Toys. So there we go with that. And just because I have this one, we got a giant turtle here, which they only, from my knowledge, they only came out with two giant turtles for the movie 3 line, which Raphael and Leonardo, they didn't make a Michelangelo and Donatello that I'm aware of. Now, I could be wrong, but from my little bit of research and from what I've seen, I've only seen Raph and Leonardo, which I don't have Raph, and I believe they both came with masks, which I don't have. But, yeah, just wanted to point that out. Looks just like, just looks like the little one here, little 4-inch figure, 3-inch figure, whatever. Very cool, though, to have that. I will definitely like to get the Raph and get their masks for these larger two figures. So that'd be a pretty cool thing to complete. But yeah, so that is it for them. Alrighty, and just so we can compare here, I put the originals in front of the NECA counterparts that came out this year. 2023 NECA figures back there. Just to show them off, guys, they look magnificent. I love the NECA figures. The originals have always been a great place in my heart. So it's nice to see these updated versions of today as well. And cool seeing them right in front of each other, next to each other, around each other, whatever. But anyways, guys, very cool Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle movie 3 figures here. Gotta love them. But we got more to see, so let's move on to the next set. Alright, so let's take a look at the secondary heroes here, the other good guys of the story. And we have six of them to look at. We'll start with this guy over here that's on the horse, just to get a closer look at him. So, there we go. Get him off the horse for a minute. Now, this is a rebel soldier, and as you can see, he kind of has a generic face. I don't think he was painted or produced to look or resemble anybody from the actual movie. But, yeah, he's got this soft good, all blue. I guess the rebel color is blue. He's got the blue bandana. He's got the soft good, you know, fabric cloth outfit thing. I don't know what you call this. But he's got that on. He's got his blue armor on here. He's got some silver arm guards. Pretty cool, nonetheless. But yeah, just a generic soldier. I guess back in the day, if you wanted to do a war, you could have army belt with this guy. But not really much else to talk about with him. Just a rebel, the good guy, rebel soldier there. Let's put him off to the side. Take a look at his horse real quick. Now, they're both in really good shape, and they came in a pack together. If anybody was wondering, this was one set all here. But yeah, so you got this armor, this fancy purple and green and all this color going on here. You got the armored mask, which you could pop this off if you wanted to, but we're going to leave that on. but yeah, you got the reins and everything here. You can hold on to that, put your feet right there. The tail is a soft good as well, can move a little bit. Yeah, not much else to the horse. Otherwise, they don't have no articulation. Nothing in the legs is a solid like piece. So, but very cool because you don't see a lot of mounts in the original Playmates line. I mean, they had a lot of vehicles, and of course they had like the dinosaur figures for the cave turtles and things like that, but it's cool to see a horse in there. So yeah, that is the rebel soldier and his armored horse, war horse here. So let's put him off to the side and take a look at the next figure here. Now this is Mitsu, I believe is how you say her name. This is the rebel leader. So yeah, wearing her blue colors again, dark blue bandana, long black flowing hair. She's just so fancy. But yeah, cool figure. I don't remember much, honestly, about these characters, about Mitsu in particular. Not much to say about her, but this is her, the rebel leader. Let's put her off to the side and take a look at the next one here. Now, this is just a disgusting rat known as Splinter. He's wearing this raggedy, you know, I don't know if it's just like the age of this, but it just feels like the rags are even worse than what they looked like before. Like, I think they've always had these little rips and tears in them, but I don't know if the age got to this. There's like white yellowing and like these nasty gray markings. I don't know if that was actually with this figure. It almost looks like somebody took an old paint cloth, you know, and just wrapped it in a figure. But yeah, why do we got to make Splinter look so filthy? I don't know. I don't know. They got to be, you know, prejudiced because he's a rat, so he has to look terrible or something. I don't know for sure. But anyways, guys, I'm rambling on about poor Splinter here and his terrible condition. But yeah, he's got pretty much all his accessories. He's missing, I believe he has a scepter as well, which I don't have. But he's got his bow and arrow. He's got his halberd-looking blade thing there. He's got his walking stick. I don't know what we're calling that. And then, of course, one of them knuckle blade things, daggers, knuckle daggers or whatever they're called. So yeah, so you got all that. And this doesn't come apart, unfortunately, like his 1988 counterpart. We don't have a special staff thing going on there. But yeah, this is it, man. This is one of the ugliest Splinters I've ever seen. And I was talking about it before, about the knockoff Turtles of the movie star figures. And I was like, I don't know where they got that ugly-looking replica rat on the knockoffs, because that doesn't look like anything like the movie star turtle. And I think it's because it's they made it after this one. They just gave it a different paint job, made him gray. If you want to know what I'm talking about, go back and watch the movie star figure video where I showed the the knockoffs. But yeah, I think that's where the mystery solved. But just look at them eyes, man. This has got to be like the worst. I don't know what the hell they did with this Splinter. Did Splinter look like this in the movie? I don't know. You guys remind me, let me know in the comments if he did. But this is a pretty crappy looking Splinter, I have to say. So let's put him off to the side here and take a look at the next guy up on the list here. Now, this is Kenshin, I believe is how you're going to say his name. Now, he is the evil warlord's son, which we'll take a look at the warlord here in a little bit. But he's actually a good guy in the story. And he comes with the scepter and whatever this thing. I don't know what you're going to call that. He has that. He's got like a katana here. He's got a knife. I think he's missing another knife, but we'll put up his box, him in the complete in the box, so you guys can see for yourself. But yeah, not much to this guy. He's got this same outfit that poor April has, which we'll just look at her now too to get them both out of the way. They're both wearing identical outfits here. She looks like she's like a little maiden or like one of them little geishas or something. I don't know if that's the same culture or not, but we're talking Japan here. But yeah, so she's wearing that little outfit here. It's been a long time since I've watched the third movie. So, yeah, I don't remember what's going on here with these guys. But, yeah, there you go. You got Kenshin and you got April. April has no accessories, but we'll put her box up now so you can see what she came with. And, yeah, that's pretty much it. Both of them in pretty decent shape. There's a little bit of paint rub on poor April's hairline there. But everything else looks really good. All right, so we got the Turtle Pult right here with Wit, which usually I don't show like vehicles or accessory things like this, but it did come with the actual figure, which is in a box still there. But yeah, I had to show this off. I do like the box art, so I won't take this out of the box. It's going to stay in there permanently, but still very cool. Real working catapult launcher. Toss the turtles in the battle. So there you go. We're just going to put a turtle on the back of this catapult and launch him. Look at that price tag. $13.99 reduced down to $4.99. Whoever bought this thing for $5. You could not find this anywhere in the original packaging for $5 nowadays. But even at the price tag, $14 back in this time was probably a lot for these turtle figures. But around, like I said, around this time, like this is pretty much the last 93 into 94 is like the last great turtle years of production. 94 wasn't even that great, but 93, yeah, I think the sales just went down drastically, and that's probably why this was reduced down so low. But if they made this Turtle Pult today, like NECA or someone decided they're going to make this stuff, man, there's no way you're going to pay $15 for it. I guarantee it's going to be like $50 to $100 easily, just the difference in the times here. But yeah, just to look at the back of the artwork here, we got, you know, the Casey Jones wit looking figure with the hockey mask on. You got the transfer pad. You got the backslide slinger. So it just tells you all the different stuff. I'm not going to go over everything. Then there's just a description, and down here, a few more pictures of other vehicles and things from other sets. And then, of course, the two horses in this set. Oh, and it has a little explanation how it works. Pretty cool. Launch Leonardo on there. But yeah, that's about it for this guy, man. We're not going to open him up. I'm not going to take him out and look at him. He's going to stay and remain. This box is in pretty decent shape for the age, but it is kind of rough. I'm not going to try to mess with it too much. But yeah, so that's about it. We're going to move on and look at a few villain figures, and we are done with the movie 3 Turtles. All right, so this is the final three figures of this line, the movie 3 Turtles. And these are the evildoers, the bad guys. So let's take a quick look at them and run by. And we'll start with this guy with the horns, this dastardly villain over here, this evil emperor of the Dark Kingdom, the Dark Empire, the Dark Warlord looking dude himself. And he's just called the Warlord. I think he has other names, but none of the stuff I said. But yes, the Warlord figure here. He's got that nasty horned helmet. He's got his samurai gear on. He does look like he's somebody that you would not necessarily want to fight in a battle, but looks could be deceiving, I guess. But he's in okay shape. He does have some marks, and he's missing some paint here and there. He doesn't have any accessories, so that's unfortunate. But again, I'll put a photo of him in his original packaging so you can get a good look at what he came with. But again, anybody that has a mustache like that, guys, in a movie or anything is probably a bad guy. It's just how it works. Anytime somebody has that type of mustache. But anyways, let's move on to the next figure. Now, this is the evil Empire soldier type deal. Now, again, this is just another generic face, not really after any certain movie star or character in the show. But he's got his little gear on here. He's wearing gray and red because he's got to look like he's, you know, Imperium type deal. He's, you know, part of the dark side. But yeah, nothing too flashy about him. That is it for this evil soldier guy here. And the evil war horse we're going to look at now. He's got, of course, the demonic looking armor. It's got to look pretty terrifying, I guess, seeing a horse decked out like this on the battlefield. But yeah, he is missing, you know, for you to put your feet right there. So on both sides, unfortunately. So he's missing that, but he does have where you can hold on to this. And the tail's also soft like the other war horse. But, yeah. Pretty cool nonetheless. Again, solid piece. Can't maneuver the legs or anything. But that is it for him. Let's take a look at the last figure right here. And this is Walker, Texas Ranger. No. But he is Walker, the Ruthless English Pirate. So, yeah, he's bringing weaponry, you know, guns and ammunition. He's killing people with that stuff. But packing pistol, he comes with the dangerous dagger, fencing foil, time-slipping scepter, and his halberd axe. And yeah, so we have all that here. He is complete. And take a closer look at him here. This guy just looks like an asshole. I mean, excuse my language, but he is truly a jerk. Like I said, it's been a while since I watched the movie, but I'm pretty sure I hated this guy when I was a kid. And just looking at him in figure form, I don't like him either. I just, you know, I'd want to smack him in the face or something. But, yeah, no, I don't know. This character just looks like he's a bad guy. He looks like a jerk. Not a fan of him. He's bringing guns to Japan and everything else. What a jerk, man. There's no honor in just shooting somebody. You got to stab them and chop their head off. That's just how it works. But, anyways, guys. That is it really for this video. Just wanted to show you guys the figures that were released for the movie 3, the third movie, whatever we want to call it. But cool Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle figures nonetheless. Anyways, guys, stay tuned for future videos. Hope you enjoyed this. Like and subscribe. I probably, like I said, I'll do one more part. I should be able to do a part 3 and finish up 1993. And like I said, we'll move on from there and see what else we got. Some figures from 94, 5, 6, 7. But anyways, stay tuned. Talk to you soon.